The answer is many, many things that we should be worried about. The attacker might not learn the exact size because of padding on the requests up to the block size. The same thing for the responses. The attacker also learns the pattern, and this reveals a lot about a web page. Because of optimizations in HTTP, there are often multiple responses to one request. This could be because a large page is broken into many responses. It could be because there are many images on the page and they get responded. And although they would normally require separate requests, because of caching, they could be sent before those requests. So these patterns are very distinguishing. Different web pages will have different sizes of responses as well as a different pattern. An example of where this is particularly dangerous in modern web applications. So we're using HTTPS connected to Google. And now when I type a letter, I get a response. It's filling up the guesses of what I'm going to type next. The size of this response depends on the letter that I typed. If I type another letter, will I get a different response? You can see that Udacity is the most popular word starting with UD, at least according to when I'm using Google. I don't know if that's true for everyone. But that size differs, and if I type another letter, will I get a different response? And so the size of these responses depend on the letters I'm typing. The length of these words will affect the size of the response. And you can build a model that would identify what someone's typing based on the sizes of these responses. And there's a paper by a group from Microsoft Research that shows some of these vulnerabilities and how much information an attacker can learn from that. There's another paper by Peter Chapman and myself, and you may remember Peter if you took CS101, he was the TA for that, that looked at ways of measuring this and understanding how much information is really leaking. So this is a serious attack. It's something that even though the encryption is there, that an attacker can learn a lot about what's going on a web page.